So what is audio drift? Well, audio drift occurs when you are shooting a video with your camera and also recording the audio with a second microphone. And when you replace your camera audio with the audio from the second microphone, well, you'll notice at the beginning of your video, the audio and video will be in sync. However, as the video plays, the audio and video begin to drift apart and be more and more out of sync. And this is what is commonly known as audio drift. So how does this happen? Well, let's play a little game, all right? There's two teams. There's the yellow team and the black team. And when the yellow team plays, they play 5 tokens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when the black team plays, they play 4 tokens, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in the first turn, you can see that the numbers just line up perfectly. Now on the second turn, you can see that the black tokens begin to go a little bit out of alignment with the yellow tokens. Another turn, and the black tokens are more out of line. And finally, a fourth turn, and you can see how the black tokens will continue to be out of line with the yellow tokens as time moves on. So this is kind of sort of what happens with the audio drift. The camera you're shooting with is recording your audio at one particular rate, and the microphone is recording at a different rate. So to start out, they're perfectly in sync, but as time goes on, they become more and more out of sync, or they have drifted apart. And that's what is called audio drift. Now, there's about 3 ways to fix this. You know, if your camera and second microphone have the same recording rates, then the audio drifting should not occur. But so far, I haven't found this to be the case. A second thing is there are also video editors with audio sync features. There's Filmora 9. I've seen it in Adobe Premiere Pro. I don't use either of those editors, so I can't really testify to how effective they are, but there are some video editors that do address this issue. And there's also various apps online that you can find. But the issue there is, you know, very often I have found that I download an app online and then I try to install it and use it only to find out it doesn't really do what I thought it was going to do. Now, a third way to fix it, and this is the way that, you know, I deal with audio drift, is to fix it with iMovie. Now, iMovie is on a Mac, so this particular fix is just for people who, you know, have a Mac and have iMovie. I've done a bunch of videos at this point. I use this technique every time. And so in this video, I'll show you how to fix the audio drift on a Mac with iMovie. All right, so this is iMovie. And here we can see I have a video clip that I shot with my iPhone. It's a guitar piece I recorded. And while I was shooting the video with my iPhone, I was also recording with a Rode NT5 matched pair set of microphones. And that's what the green file is. This is a external audio file that was recorded the same time as I was shooting the video. So let's bring the video file into the timeline. You know, and you know, as you would expect, you know, the video and the audio that was shot by the iPhone are in sync. There's no drifting or sync problems at all, as you would expect. It's shot by the same camera. So there you go. You can see that sounds fine. The guitar notes and the finger picking are all lining up. So the question becomes, you know, how do you marry up the externally recorded audio with the video clip? So the way I do it is I insert a couple of sync points. And what I mean by that is, and this is a technique that is very simple, and a lot of people do it. You might remember in like old movies, there was a little slate board that they would clack on to make a noise. So it's kind of like that. Just do a hand clap at the beginning of the shoot, and then I do a hand clap at the end of the shoot. So then I have two sync points to marry up the external audio. As you can see, the hand clap gives you a nice spike. Here is the spike of the hand clap in the video file. And here is the spike in the hand clap from the external audio file. So now in iMovie, you have to do it manually. You grab a hold of the file and you drag it until you line up those spikes. And this does get to be a bit tedious. You get better at it, you know, as you do more of it. So let's take a listen. All right, so you can hear that there's kind of a chatter there. There's a clap clap, so they're not quite lined up perfectly yet, or as close to perfect as you would might like. Move it to the left a little bit. Still getting that chatter clap. Try it again. There you go. So listen to it one more time. All right, so it's kind of a clear, crisp, you know, one clap sound. So the first sync point has been lined up. So then we want to go to the end of the clip for the end sync points. You know, and here you can see how the audio file from the Rode microphones is not in sync or falls out of sync towards the end of the video. And you can listen to the claps. Yeah, so they're way out of sync. Now, to make things a little easier, what I tend to do is trim off the back end of the clips. Do a split clip there. And then do a split clip on the audio file. And iMovie, when you split them like that in the same spot, iMovie connects the audio file with the video file. So if you just select on the video file, hit delete, and it's gone. So now I'm going to show you the steps to sync up the audio and resolve the drifting problem. So first thing is, you want to select the audio file. And you go up here to this speedometer icon. It's the speed icon. You want to click on that. And that will display a drop-down list. And on the drop-down list, you have selections for normal, slow, fast, freeze frame, and custom. You want to pick custom. And when you pick custom, a data field displays. And here you just want to alter this or adjust this field. It doesn't really matter, you know, what number or you use. I usually just change it to be 101. That seems to work pretty well. And when you do that, you'll notice some changes happened here in the audio file. You get this, you know, little bunny rabbit icon. And it adds another handle up here on top of the audio file. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to grab that handle and I'm going to stretch the audio file over to the right in order to line up the two claps. Now there is one unfortunate thing is that when you do grab this handle and begin to stretch it out, the actual rendering here goes blank. So you'll just see a blank green green file like so. So you kind of have to play around. And again, it's a little tedious and you get better at it the more you do it. Here I can see I need to go over to the right just a little bit more. That's a little too much. That might be okay. Let's take a quick listen. Yeah, I mean, that sounds pretty right on. Let's listen again. Yeah, that sounds good. So let's just go back to the beginning so I can show you that even though we stretched out the audio file, the beginning clap is still in sync. Here you go. And let's sample. The center of the video here. Yeah, I mean, it sounds good. The fingers and the notes are syncing up. And in that sampling, we were actually playing both of these audios simultaneously, and they were syncing up quite well. So the last step is to detach the audio from the video and then marry up the external audio with the video. So what I usually do just to make sure I just get rid of that audio completely, take the volume down, select it, and here I select detach audio, and that removes the audio from the video clip. It puts it down at the bottom. And just select it and delete. Gone. Let's take another quick listen. Yeah, still looks good, sounds good. So the only thing left to do is to select these two files and render it out to the desktop. And you do that in iMovie by going to share and you say file. And we give it a name. We synced audio. No audio drift. Just hit next, and we'll save this to the desktop. You know, and that's it. Now, it'll take a few moments for these files to render out to the desktop. So let's just, we'll end this clip right here, and I'll show you the rendered file. All right, so here is the file that was exported from iMovie. Let's take a quick look. Shrink it up a little bit and hit like the middle of the video. So that's it. That was a successful fix to an audio drift issue. So I was able to successfully marry up the audio from the Rode NT5 mics with the video that was shot with my iPhone. So this is a solution that is for Mac using iMovie. I've not yet seen a similar kind of solution on a Windows platform, but when and if I do, I will certainly put out another tutorial to explain how that would work. So in the meantime, I hope this was helpful to you, and we'll see you next time.